The sunlight spills from a high-up window.
My lunch from today spills out of my guts. So episode 2 immediately has him going after yet another girl, but at least this one isn't completely exaggerated.
Beauty, Daro.
I hate you. I'll spare you the details and say that this episode is essentially about him helping out with some mayor win an election.
This is a really dirty election.
Says the man who drank out of a toilet.
Later, a lady asks to take the day off to take care of her son who is sick. Kentaro, in an attempt to see the girl from before again, volunteers to do it for her.
Her name is Naoko.
No!
Beautiful angel sits here, and then she...
You can't be serious!
Oh, I can't believe it! Oh, it's impossible to believe such a thing!
What is the show's problem? They're already reusing a joke, and it's only the second episode? And it wasn't even funny the first time! What is wrong with these idiots?!
Of course, he's caught again, and for some reason, the girl asks him to come back to her room so he can clean up.
I lose control of my precious bodily fluid. Oh, if only my hand was my penis.
I don't believe I'm actually saying this, but this episode is worse than the last one.
And then, defying all logic, the girl actually changes clothes in front of him.
Are you dense? This was a man that was rubbing his face all over your toilet. You should be calling the police! He is clearly dangerous!
Turns out I'm wrong. This girl's father is the soon-to-be mayor of the city, and she knows that no man would ever touch her, and she decides to make Kentaro her personal play toy. The next day, she spots Kentaro in the street and gives him a letter. It's implied that she wants to get it on with him, but she's actually just teasing him by saying she wants help with math. This happens again and again. Each time they're wearing even less clothes than before, she eventually discovers Kentaro's notebook and steals it for herself. But while she's reading it, she has a startling revelation. Not only does she find out that Kentaro isn't falling for a scam, but he thinks he's doing her a favor for sticking around. Not wanting to be the fool, she gets revenge by cutting her clothes up and making everyone think Kentaro tried to rape her. But Kentaro says that he is in love with her. Naoko starts to have second thoughts.
Give him the treatment! Go ahead!
He leaves the next day after nearly getting killed, but then for some reason no one tries to kill him because of some crap about not making excuses for being with Naoko and...
Kentaro Oe, age 25.
Hi again, narrator. It's, the end of the episode again. You're not needed, so, go away.
In our last episode, Kentaro works for a noodle shop.
My name is Kentaro
Oe. You know,
Oe.
I just realized something.
How is he getting all these jobs to begin with? He leaves when no one wants him around, leaving him with no credible references. He quit college, which means he has no degree, saying why he should have this job over someone else. And third, when he comes to the job, he has zero experience. What the hell?
The love... for lack of a better word, object in this episode is Noriko, a so far seemingly normal girl who is the daughter of the head chef in the restaurant. But Kentaro isn't the only one with the hots for her. It seems that a businessman who has been funding them also has an eye for her as he invites her to see his ship.
Would you consent to marry?
Once there, he asks her to marry him. Talk about straightforward, but Kentaro finds out he's not the nice man he seems to be as he overhears his plan to marry Noriko to own the noodle shop only to shut it down.
Excuse me, I'm sorry to bother you. Did you mean what you just said?
You are literally dumber than the last two episodes combined.
Kentaro then proceeds to ask him nicely not to do what he says he will. Naturally, he gets his ass handed to him.
Show you how cruel I can be!
Ow! The next day at work, Noriko leaves to go on a date with the Mr. Kukure, is his name, I guess, and he asks again if she wants to marry him. She says that she's worried about what will happen to her family's noodle shop if she does, so he takes it up a notch, but thankfully Kentaro is there to stop him.
We're not husband and wife yet. We shouldn't.
Her lips say no, but I'm sure her body will soon say yes. First of all, let's take things from the top.
I don't think so.
What?
Not in this lifetime, pal.
What the hell? Oh, first I need to keep these hands busy. Damn, these things are huge. She's so hot and worked up, she almost sounds like a man.
After playing around, Mr. Kukure then kisses Kentaro, thinking it's Noriko. And the stupidest part about all this, besides the fact that he actually kissed a man, is Noriko's eyes are closed the whole time and doesn't see a damn thing. But this crap continues as that night back at home while Noriko is talking to Kentaro, she actually says she is planning on marrying Kukure. Why hasn't Kentaro told her of Kukure's plan? Why does he continue to be a dumbass? Better question, why am I still watching this show? Noriko leaves to find Kukure in an attempt to make up her mind, but she finds that Kentaro has gotten to him first.
Please, please leave Noriko alone, Mr. Kogure.
You moron! We've been trying for weeks to bump off her father. What makes you think we give up on this?
I'm begging you, please! I swear I won't tell anybody.
You think she's a good girl, huh? The other day I got that little slut so hot she was moaning like a bitch in heat!
That is one seriously perverted bitch. My patience is wearing thin. Huh?
Uh-huh. Noriko! Noriko! Let me introduce you! This is my girlfriend, whose name is also Noriko. She's been a nasty, perverted, kinky hooker ever since she was little, and we're just talking about her.
Yes, that's right. Kentaro was introducing me to her.
No, 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 no. I could buy the harem software company. I could tolerate him rubbing his face against the toilet, not once, but twice. But you expect me to believe this?
Not only have you caught the criminal in the act with confession, but you've managed to get Noriko to overhear so she won't have to marry the bastard, and you're now pretending you were talking about something else?
This makes no sense!
But thank God someone in this episode has a brain, as Noriko says she doesn't believe him and leaves. The next day, as Kentaro is about to leave, Noriko apologizes and it's emphasized that she has fallen in love with him and blah, blah, blah.
End. Thank God that ends our third episode. Now, let's take a look back for thank God the last time.
Golden Boy isn't as bad as it is just plain retarded. Episode 1 is offensive, Episode 2 decides to recycle jokes from Episode 1, and Episode 3 is just... stupid. The entire show is full of bad jokes wrapped up in poor voice acting by the lead, who I have grown to hate. This is the worst anime I have seen in a long time.
Now that said, if you're looking for a smarter anime, then I suggest watching School Rumble. Hell, even Ninja Nonsense makes more sense in this show. Watch one of those, avoid this at all costs. I'm Subarashi, this is Anime 130 signing out.
Morning.
Morning.
How's it feel to have just completed the episode?